Trapper's Cabin. We are going to play the Hopeless Rescue Challenge. And this is Russ Cooper, mod at the Long Dark Community on Facebook, and owner-operator of thelongdarksurvivors.wordpress.com. And I'm just going to commentate on my gameplay. And give some hints or tips and explain why I'm doing what I'm doing. And hopefully it will be of some help or use to you. Should be noted that I'm not playing this for speed. If I was, I wouldn't be searching the entire cabin. But I tend to take pretty much everything. I also had to remind myself, hey, look, you're not playing in a sandbox where you have your fire making badge. You've got to take paper for tinder and all sorts of stuff that you wouldn't normally do. Just because there's a rifle here at 90% or less, I'm going to be messing about with the maximum weight level anyway, simply because of wanting to carry that. So, one thing I do always do when I play this challenge is get the stuff in the safe. Sometimes it's better than others. Sometimes you get moccasins, sometimes you get more rifle rounds, sometimes you get extra flare shells, but I always do it because it can give you a nice boost in your clothing stats. And sometimes the weather just sounds a bit nasty, kind of like it does now. It's definitely blowy outside, so any sort of bonus I can get would be great. Rifle, flare, MRE. That's a pretty good haul. MRE, I'm definitely cool with. Sometimes I don't take the antibiotics because I don't necessarily want the extra weight, but I'll grab that jerry can. Sometimes I'll refuel my lantern and leave the rest of the fuel behind because I know I'm going to find more, but other times I'll cart it with me. This lantern is an awesome lantern. And load up my rifle, but we'll head out. Now, I grabbed that because I didn't exactly see the state of my rifle, but it's at 90%. But might as well make it 100, right? Not too bad out. So there's a backstory to why I end up going the way I go. And not to the right. And that is because one of the more recent streams I did, I actually went to the right, went around the rocks by the little shack down there, and nearly ran right into Mr. Bear. And Mr. Bear could have mauled the heck off me. He didn't, but he could have. So now I take a slightly different route. I end up going to the same place, but I circumnavigate around potential bear so that I can simply continue on my way. Yeah, it takes a little more time and a little more energy, but it gets you safely around so that you don't really have to worry about the danger of an early mauling, which would set you back a whole bunch of time and probably potentially even ruin your attempt at completing Hopeless Rescue. You'll also notice that I don't run everywhere. There's no point. I'm either going to get it done in 7 days or I'm not. And just for the record, looks like there was no bear there anyway, so I could have gone that way and come up through there and gone over the top. But I have no way of knowing that, so I decided to play it safe. Make sure I made it up. And now we're moving again. You'll notice I also keep my rifle stowed when I'm climbing hills. That's because I want to have my hands free in case I'll stumble. Which seems like a pretty likely thing to happen when you don't know what the ground underneath the snow is actually like. Grab a few sticks. This is to make starting a fire easier. But I'll come down to the right, bring out my rifle now because I'm going downhill. And come out into the deadfall area. My general game plan is to, once I leave the cabin, is to get over here, go through that hole, check the little broken cabin for the potential hatchet, because it's a hatchet spawn point. Then make my way to camp office, which I will then check for useful items before I continue onward to the dam. But there was the always a question of which route I will take to get to the dam. So what we got this time? We've got the hatchet. So I've already got a weight of tools. I love the music. This game. And the sounds, which reminds me, I've got to start my ASMR Pilgrim sandbox. It'll be totally different than what I do here, but no less entertaining. So you'll notice that I'm looking to the left and to the right quite a bit. That is to scan for a potential wolf that likes to patrol this area. But I don't see him. He's not there. At least it seems like he's not there. He might be there, and I'm just missing him. But I haven't heard his alert sound yet, so I don't believe I'm in any danger of being found out. Wondering, I am playing this on an i3 powered laptop. It runs quite spankingly well when you're actually playing it. It is only later on in the video and watching it play back that one notices the artifact. And that's usually why when I do the recording, I do it in this manner where I review my gameplay and speak over it. So we're in camp office now. That's not to say I don't do live recording, but it just didn't work out for when I tried to do it for this challenge. Or the next one that I'm gonna do. So I decided, at least on the challenges, to record my commentary separately and then mix it together. I came in here to look for head coverings, because I don't think I have any. The lack of head covering will make your core temperature plummet pretty darn fast. This one, I forget whether I have a can opener or not. So, might as well grab it. I'm getting plenty of fluids. Let's see what we got up here. We got some worn running shoes. They're better. You notice how I still keep my leather running shoes, or my leather shoes. That's so I potentially break them down later. I will take any painkillers I can find. And now I'm gonna repair the clothes that I have. Or at least, repair some of them. I also have to decide whether or not I'm going to push through into the oncoming darkness in order to try and make it to the dam before sunset. And if you know me, and if you paid attention there, I decided to stop fixing stuff up pretty quickly. That's because mentally I was like, you know what? I really want to make it to the dam before I go to sleep. I'm opening my cans because cans weigh more than any of the other food. So if I get them out of my pack, at least I'll be can free. So, I try to eat my cans first. So, I know that I'm going to take a potential condition hit by doing this, but I've made my decision. I'm going to head to the dam. So, you're heading or the first fishing hut when you take this route. And sometimes you can't even see it, but if you aim yourself pretty much to the last plants and then run it straight or walk straight, you will hit it. It can sometimes seem to take forever if it's very foggy, but you'll definitely hit it. And I'm running now because I'm gonna be sleeping in the dam. So I don't necessarily need to worry myself too much about running out of energy. I'm gonna have to sleep in the dam, whether I want to or not. that's how it's worked out. And that's partially because I've checked a lot of stuff. The game defaults to a certain amount of time for checking. One of the reasons I come to this one is because it's 99% of the time there's a hatchet. There's a hatchet there right now, but I've already got one, so I don't need to take that one. I will always take any granola bars as long as they're not disgusting and moldy. Stale's fine. But still got nothing on my head. So now I have a slight problem with my plan to get to the dam. There's a wolf there. I really don't want him to engage him. I could easily fire a rifle shot and get him to go away. Then he'll come back, usually more inquisitive and more determined than ever to check me out. So I go over here to the saddleback, as I call it, and hike on up. Now by following this, you'll eventually get to a potential bunker spawn, if you follow it all the way to the end. I usually put rifle over when I'm climbing hills, but this time I didn't, and I saw that I could load a new round that I forgot I picked up. So to get to the potential bunker spawn, you just continue all the way down this until it terminates, and look around and you might find it. It's, I believe, a clothing bunker. Oh look, there's the bear. The bear's down on the lake, but we don't have to worry about him. He won't see us up there. I'm really going this way to avoid not one but two wolves. If I can avoid the two wolves, then we're doing pretty darn peachy. I know I'm going to be taking a stupid condition hit. I don't like it, but I also know that I'll be sleeping it off and I'll be fine in the morning. So you just live with it. I mean, you imagine the character would be complaining bitterly about getting so darn cold. He's not got much in the way of clothing. And there's the music that means, hey, you might want to get out of town. Get somewhere undercover. You got about an hour, maybe half an hour left of daylight. This is the first time I saw this cairn, so I had to check it out. Weather is getting consistently worse. So you're coming in over the area where you might find the saplings, and there's often a wolf there. And there he is. He's climbing the hill, but he's looking away from us, so I decide to fly in the face of potential springs and run my butt off. And of course, he doesn't see me. This weather is like really gnarly. It's not as super gnarly as it can get, but it's gnarly enough. I've taken a three-quarter condition hit now, if you will, to my weakness. I'm getting more and more tired, and it's going down fast, because I was running. I only come down here if there's no wolf. There's a potential for a pry-bar spawn. I did not want to take that. And I did not want to do that either. That's what I want. Thank you. Nope. Oh, negative 22. Run for your life. No, I take the time to drop the knife that I didn't want to pick up. And start reloading on the fly. Now you have to be careful in this area now, because this is one of two areas that I know of in Mystery Lake where the moose can spawn. So this isn't just an area you can blaze through anymore, just in case he's around. Because he'll take notice of you the moment you enter an area. actually one of three places because, well, we'll see that in my next challenge. But suffice it to say, sometimes the moose is down here by the Frozen River. And he'll take notice of you, and he won't necessarily like you being there. He might charge you if you don't get out of dodge, so I'm saving up my run here. And of course there's the potential for the lone wolf to the right. So there's no moose. We got a potential of the lone wolf up here by the trailers. But I'm not running yet. I can always fire a warning shot across his bow if I have to. Generally speaking, I will always check the trailer to the right before I get into the dam, because I probably won't be going back that way. If I'm playing a survival sandbox, I'll always check it after them, because I have a pry bar, and one of the lockers only opens with the pry bar. Didn't expect that. I missed it, but forgot to record while I was in there, so I may or may not have a headgear now. I can't honestly remember. I probably don't. I always close the gate behind me. And this is the end of the first episode of the Hopeless Rescue Commentary Challenge. Next time, we're going through the dam and beyond. So thanks for joining me. And I hope you enjoy this. Come back for the next episode. This has been Ross Cooper, and thanks for watching. I'm now going to take a really long nap, and then search the dam probably later. See ya!